My name is Antonio Rodriguez Engelmann, and I'm the Managing Director at GBSB Global Business School. GBSB Global was founded with one purpose, which was to bring innovation to the higher education ecosystem. And I would say or summarize it in three different ways, or from three different angles. The first one being innovation via our program portfolio, where we always try to have the latest industry trends and market needs from employers embedded within our curriculum. A second way is thanks to our pedagogical approach, in which innovation is really important and a powerful lever to boost economic growth. With this in mind, our head of program development and innovation, Dr. Olga Ivanova, did her own research in higher education. She developed a specific framework by which she identified competencies that were key in order to make sure that anyone graduating in a higher education program is able to boost innovation wherever he goes or she goes. So with this in mind, we developed a specific framework, and we scientifically proved in this research that we are able to measure the starting level of a student and when the student terminates their studies, in which point they are, and to measure the difference and how they improved their competencies to drive innovation. It can be in a corporate, it can be in a startup, wherever they go. So, and this is something which is really innovative within the industry and something that it's an intangible asset for us. The third aspect is how we drive innovation through entrepreneurship projects. We designed several years ago our own startup accelerator program, where we try to support students to bring to life their own entrepreneurial ideas. We have designed a program where we converge three different axes. One is the social impact. I mean, projects that we support need to have a social impact component. Second aspect, very key, is a digital business component. We are naturally more oriented towards digital services. And the third component is related to circular economy. So any kind of project that encompasses all these three aspects, it's a key project for us in which we are delighted to support anyone in this area. The program has been quite successful during the last years. We even have been recognized by the Catalan government. And since then, we have been managing social European funds to support our students in this endeavor. In my opinion, I think there are three specific factors I would like to highlight. One, and it's most important one, is our global touch, or our level of diversity. It's, I think, something unbelievable that we have around 90 to 100 different nationalities. It's quite unbelievable going into a classroom and having people coming from 20 different countries in the same classroom. So this means that at the end of the day, our students get enriched, yes, because they see how other cultures manage or face different problems in many different ways. And they value a lot in their student satisfaction surveys that this is a tremendous ingredient that we have and that no one imagines until they come and arrive here to our campus. So in this regard, I think the global factor is something that which is within our DNA. It's who we are, and this is why Global is in our name of our institution. Yeah? So a second factor, it's regarding the employability orientation that our institution has. We are very oriented towards the industry in two different ways. One is by selecting faculty that have both the theoretical framework, but also the industry experience to come into a classroom and show both the theoretical, but also the application and the applicability of this theory within the industry, to show latest trends in the industry, the challenges that they are facing, and so on. And the second thing about employability is regarding the level of opportunities that we generate for our students. Students can opt to apply for an internship in a company, or with our relationships with companies, we are continuously recycling the offer that we provide to them in terms of employment options. So whenever they terminate their studies, they may opt for different job placements or opportunities around the world. So the last thing which I would like to highlight is about the student learning experience. We are a very technological oriented school in the sense that we try to provide a fully digital experience starting from their admission stage until their graduation. We are deploying always all kind of digital portals and assets. For instance, we have a 100% online library where students can easily read all the bibliography in their iPads or in their tablets without having to go to a physical library. For that reason, we partnered as well several years ago with Microsoft. So all our student learning experiences leveraged by Microsoft technologies. And thanks to this effort that we did back in the day, we were recognized as a showcase business school by Microsoft. Yeah. Well, I think that our main objective is to maintain GBSB Global as a relevant player or a relevant option for our students in the future. And for this, to make it a reality, we need to pay attention to four different areas. The first one of them would be to continue with our approach when it comes to updating continuously the program portfolio, embedding new industry trends or new employers' demands within our curriculum so that we don't get an obsolete program portfolio in the years to come. Also, we need to review our pedagogical approach when it comes to the delivery of these programs. For instance, we had this year ChatGPT racing, yeah. And obviously this poses specific challenges to higher education institutions. In this respect, obviously, we need to know how to see them not as threats, but as opportunities. The second aspect is to continue with the academic excellence. It's not like a topic you hear on a daily basis, but quality assurance, it's a very strategic aspect for us. This is what makes us strive for excellence, to make our services to students year over year much better. Obviously, this is something that we need to always consider because this is the only way to surpass our students' expectations. Another third company is the EdTech industry, educational technology. It is right now booming all over the world. You can see every week news about new funding, investments, startups. We have a kind of new industry that is growing bigger and bigger every year. And with it, there are many, many, many different opportunities that we need to have a look at, to understand, and to know how we can articulate when it comes to improving the student experience or the service delivery towards our students or other stakeholders. We already saw this with ChatGPT, but this is only the very first wave of what is coming ahead. I foresee a huge transformation during the next decade. And here the question is not what are you going to change, but how are you going to change when it comes to delivering services to your stakeholders? Because obviously artificial intelligence will bring lots of new approaches, and for sure, this will be incredible. Also, the last thing is related to our research. We want, and it is one of our objectives, to increase the level of research by launching a new doctoral program so that our students, those who would like to continue their research activity, could have an opportunity at GBSB Global in order to pursue their PhD. And for sure, I mean, with this, we would like also to intensify our research activity internationally.